Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to the Alma College Anderson Chapel. At this time, we invite you to please silence all cell phones and to remember that recording of any kind is prohibited. Thank you for coming to support the Alma College Choir, and we hope that you enjoy the show.
joining us. I'm Christopher Cook. I'm visiting director of choirs here at Alma College. I thought it would be a good idea to introduce myself, since you've attended concerts over years. You would know that this podium has been occupied by the same person for 40 years or so. That would be my good friend and esteemed colleague, Dr. Will Nichols. So it's my honor to be here and to lead these students in tonight's performance. And a brief shameless plug, again on our Masterworks concert on April 7th. Please put it in your calendars, and you can come and hear Maurice Duruflé's iconic Requiem, a great, great piece. The program this evening is a little bit unique, and I wanted to share a few thoughts with you about it. Its foundation begins with Eric Whitaker's poignant and beautiful work, The Sacred Veil. So the concert itself is framed by movements of The Sacred Veil at the beginning, in the middle, and at the end. The inspiration for the work came from his longtime collaborator, the poet Charles Silvestri, who some years before he wrote these poems had lost his wife, Julie, to ovarian cancer. And as they told the story, it took Silvestri some years before he could process and write about, of course, what was a very traumatic event. So, at one level, of course, the piece is incredibly poignant, right, and very gripping, and sad at some moments, right, a very palpable sense of grief. However, the more I read them, I found that they spoke often of life, of hope, and of the infinite. And you'll hear this stated right from the very beginning. And one little thing that you might listen for will happen at the very beginning, and then it will be repeated a couple of times through the work. And that is the very simple motive of a minor third, that is the motive that represents Julie, his wife who had died from ovarian cancer. And you'll hear it several times in the piece. And it'll be played by the piano at some points. You'll hear it in the cello. And each time you hear that, it is to her memory. But Silvestri himself said that one of the most important ideas in the piece comes from a strophe in the first poem. Our loved one stands so close, right here, just on the other side of eternity. I wanted to comment upon Whitaker's piece by first using some words from Psalms. That'll be the next group in the program that you hear. And as David Lang, the eminent composer, said, Psalms represent all of the ways to have a conversation with God. And in my life as a choral musician, we always spoke of music as being either sacred or secular. But in time, I think many of us in music, right, any creative act is in and of itself sacred. So you're going to hear a group of poems that each in their own way, I think, continue to take us down the path of this musical journey of the soul. And finally, the other primary component is, since Whitaker used the cello as the primary instrumental voice, I wanted to include some of the most profound music that I know, and that is a couple of movements that you will hear from the cello suites of J.S. Bach. These works composed for solo cello invite us into a different place, but a place also that's filled with beauty and power and deep expression. Okay, we're gonna start the rest of the program in a second, and here's my final request of you. When I put this program together and I envisioned how it might unfold, I saw it going as directly from one thing to the next with no pause. So we'll go directly from one piece to the next. James will put in a few short interludes, but I'd like to ask you, if you're willing, and I think it'll take about 50 minutes, if you would just simply take in this program starting here in a few seconds for the next 50 minutes without any applause. And then I invite you, when we get to the end of the program, please applaud with gusto at that point. That would be very much appreciated. Thank you so much for being with us this evening.
Thank you. Thank you. the show.